Sure.
Maybe walking around.
Maybe one of the kids is getting up, or a fisherman got up, or something.
Yeah.
And can't think of it. Continue just packing everything up, and ready to go. Like, go back up and just talk to her again, maybe real fast. And go into their room, her master bedroom. She wasn't in there.
Okay, you went there first?
Yeah.
And why did you go up again?
Just to go up and talk to her again.
Okay. So it's not as though that noise made you run up, you just thought?
No, I didn't. Okay. Red paint in the register or anything like that. I just looked in the monitor and it was on Bella.
And where is the monitor? Where's the screen that you look at? Is it up or downstairs?
Upstairs.
Okay, so you go upstairs, look at the monitor.
Yeah, everything's right beside the bed.
Oh, your master bed. Okay,
yeah,
all right.
Beside the bed.
So she's not in her bed.
It's still right there.
Okay.
So you want to look at it. And it was on Bella. Her covers were pulled back. She was just sprawled out laying there. And then it cycled over. So they got 3, 4, 5 second like interval between when it cycles from room to room. I cycled over to Susie's room. That's when I saw her on top of her. That's when I ran in.
Okay. So can we talk about, again, it's very, very hard to talk about, but it's good to make sure that we understand. We don't want anything to be incorrect or inaccurate or anything like that. Was your wife on top of Susie? What did that look like? I mean, was she straddling her? Okay. And where were they?
In the bed.
On the bed. And so your wife was on top, is it? I mean, was she
doing this? That's when I was walking up from the back.
Okay. I've seen some from the back.
Yeah.
Okay. But she was doing this.
It looked like it was like this.
Yeah. Okay. And then was she face up, face down? What?
Off to the side.
Oh, she was laying on her side. Okay.
And that's when I pulled her off. And
okay.
She was limp and she was blue.
Okay.
There was no movement at all.
Oh. She was limp and blue, or limping and blue?
Limp and blue.
Okay.
It's like her body was like...
Right.
You pick her arm up and she just falls.
Okay. And then what happened?
I looked at her and I just got on top of her and...
You got on top of Shanann?
Did the same thing.
Okay. Did you have to knock her down?
No.
She was already on the ground?
I just pulled her off on the bed.
Oh, kind of one movement?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's not as though you pulled her off?
No, like I went up, pulled her down, okay. And did that. I didn't know, I lost it.
Sure. Okay.
So Shanann was laying on the ground?
On the bed.
On the bed?
Yeah, like when she was on top of the seat, I saw what was happening. I pulled her and went down.
How
big was
the bed? What kind of size is it? Full, clean,
It's probably a queen of some sort.
Okay.
I have a pick for those more, I think.
Okay. So where was the last? In the
she was all the way to the top.
To the top?
Yeah. And I went in and pulled Shanann down. It was a crossways.
Like
so she was laying this way. That's how it was.
Okay. And that's key room. So then, is this picture as you're standing in the doorway to go in? What is that? Is that where? Okay. And then, so were they closer to this side or this side?
Cece usually sits in the middle.
Okay. And then, so your wife was right on top of her. You could just see that. And then, did you pull her this way or that way? Or
so to where her head was on this side.
Right over here?
Yeah.
On the left as you're looking at it. Okay. Did she put up a fight?
I lost it so much that it didn't feel like she did.
Okay. You're a pretty strong dude. Did she, was she yelling? Was she screaming? Was she talking? Was she scratching you? Nothing?
I just felt such anger that nothing, I didn't feel anything.
Okay.
Like if she did, nothing's on me.
Was it quick? Was it slow? Was it?
So now that felt like it was over.
Fast? Over fast? Okay.
Felt like I would.
Is it possible her neck's broken?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
I've never broken a bone, so I don't know.
Okay. All right. Was it a choke like this, or was it like a headlock?
A choke.
Okay.
Can you put your hand out like you had your hand?
Like that?
Right.
And your wife, you saw her with one hand or two hands?
I just kind of from the back, I couldn't really like tell. Well, she was on top of her. And the monitor's not like color, it's black and white. Well, yeah. Nighttime, it's black and white.
Okay.
It's dark.
Because you went up the stairs, right, to talk to Shanann again? And then, did you think it was weird that she's not in the room where you left her?
Mm-hmm. So I walked in and looked around and saw the monitor and I saw Bella. And then switched over to CT pretty fast, and that's when I saw that.
Did you have any inkling that between the time that you finished the talk and the time that you found Shanann choking, she had no inkling she was going to do it?
Sure. The Buffaloes get more than you know.
Okay.
And people in my family have always said she's unstable. My friends have said she's unstable, but I never like would have thought in a million fucking years.
Who says she's unstable?
My family, my friend Mark, people that have seen her around me. I have a picture of her.
Well, it doesn't look good, I'm not gonna lie. Looks actually pretty bad.
Is it possible that when we get these girls, you know, Bella, Cece, and Shanann, is it possible when we get them that we're going to see anything other than the cause of death being her hands?
No.
Okay. And what I mean by that, and I should be very clear, is that it's some of it's hard to believe that your wife did it.
I know.
Right? You can imagine that.
I know.
Okay. So is it possible that maybe she did one and then you got Shanann, so you did to Shanann what she did to one of your daughters, and then you had to just do it to the other one, to make. Okay. So is there, that's not,
no.
That's not what happened?
No.
Okay. Is it possible that, is there any other way where we might see your hands on the girl's neck?
No. Lord,
okay.
No.
Okay. And you know what I mean? Because when we find their little bodies,
I know.
We're going to see the diameter of someone's hand,
yeah.
And someone's fingers. Right? So is it at all possible we're going to see yours?
Okay. No.
All right. And I know it's hard, and I know you're probably getting angry at my question, but we have to ask. Okay.
What do you think about Chris?
Let my family down. Let my dad down. Let my mom, sister, nephew, nieces. Friends, co-workers, everybody.
Can I ask you another tough question? Can you just get it all on the table? When you see Shanann choking, strangling Celeste, and you get her off of Celeste, do you think about calling an ambulance? How come?
I saw CT lying there blue and limp.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I've never seen something like that in my life. I mean, she just like lay over, like nothing was, she wasn't moving at all. No gasp of breath.
So
she was totally just blue.
So Chris, doing this job for a long time.
I know.
I know a lot about psychology and as far as like what people are thinking. And most parents will never even want to fathom that their kid, or kid is dead. Even if their kid's stiff, blue in bed, I mean stiff like been dead all night, they still call an ambulance to see if someone can revive their child. And they, when the ambulance gets there and they're like, gosh, their kid's been dead all night, like there's nothing we can do. And the parents are like, what are you, why are you not doing something? What are you talking about? So that's what we're used to. So I just, that's why I want you to explain to me like what was going on in your head and.
Very last felt for what she did. It just took over.
But do you see that?
I understand. I see where you're coming from.
Most parents would still try and call.
I see where you're coming from.
Yeah. I would hate for Shanann to get a bad rap. She didn't have anything to do with it. You know, it's not fair.
I know.
It's not fair. Like, enough bad stuff has happened.
I know.
Like, we need to stop the bad stuff from happening. So, do you want to tell the truth?
That is the truth.
So you're good with the public knowing that Shanann killed her daughters?
I did not hurt these girls.
Are you okay with the public knowing that Shanann?
Yes, because I did not hurt these girls.
Chris, I'm not sure what to do.
Would be there, any of this makes sense.
Are you sure Shanann didn't catch you in
trouble? No, my God, no.
Chris, you can imagine that we're pretty cynical in our jobs, right? And tonight we've had to talk a lot about a lot of things, and don't get mad, but what it looks like is that you found a new life, and the only way to get that new life was to get rid of your old life. And I think that you killed these girls before their mom came home, and then killed you now. And that's what we're kind of left, that's what we have to believe, because it just doesn't make sense. I mean, to her point, if I walked in and my kid was decapitated, I'd call an ambulance,
mm-hmm.
right?
So knowing there's no hope.
It just doesn't make sense. It just doesn't add up. So either you're this monster who says, I just want this young, hot girlfriend, so I'm going to kill everyone and hope it works out, or something. So I think we're very, very close to the truth, but not quite there yet. So if you're not that monster.
I'm not a monster. I didn't. Kill my babies.
Okay. So, tell us what actually happened.
I told you what happened.
I know, but, you know, we're getting later into the day. We've done this a few times, and we talk, then we show you a little bit of what we're working with, some evidence and facts that we know, and then we kind of get our way to the truth.
So, the truth.
Okay.
Everything I've told you, truth.
So what's going to happen when their cause of death comes back to you, for the girls?
Not going to.
Okay. You sure?
I'm 100% positive it's not going to come back to me.
Who's going to come back to?
Shanann was on top of CC.
Okay.
What do you want me to say?
I just want the truth.
That's the truth.
And then what about Bella?
Bella was laid out, sprawled on her bed.
Okay.
And I saw Shanann on top of CC, so I ran in there.
And what happens when a coroner looks and says, sees your fingerprints on her neck?
It's not going to be my fingerprints.
Okay. What is it going to be?
It's going to be Shanann's.
Are you sure? Well, we don't know about Bella, right? We don't know about
Bella. Bella, I didn't see Shanann on top of her.
Okay.
That's the commotion I heard upstairs.
Yeah.
I'm assuming.
Okay. Why take their bodies out of the house and bury them?
I was scared. I didn't know what else to do.
Okay.
Nothing was gonna... I didn't know what to do.
Yeah.
Scared. I honestly didn't know what to do.
Scared of what?
Scared of what everything was gonna look like. My two babies were gone.
Mm-hmm.
And I just did that to my wife. And I was the only one left in the house. What do you expect was gonna happen?
Yeah. It did look bad, right?
This was a nightmare.
Yeah. Okay.
Just think, as many problems as you've had with Shanann, at the end of the day, she seemed like she was a pretty good mom, right?
I was a pretty good dad as well. You never really know a person until you don't know a person.
Would hate for someone who can't defend themselves, like Shanann and Bella and Celeste. If you're not being truthful about who took their lives, like, that's on them too.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't want to do that to them.
I'm not doing that to them.
I'm just saying.
I'm not doing that to them.
I do think you were a good dad. I think Shanann was a good mom. I think you guys were doing everything you could possibly do for those girls. I mean, look at them.
Why didn't you put Shanann in the tanks?
I didn't know what else to do.
How far down is she?
I don't know, like 2 feet maybe.
How long did it take you to dig that?
No.
Give me an idea.
20, 30 minutes.
Does anyone ever go up this ladder and look in tanks?
Mm-hmm.
So how are you going to avoid that? Or is it you that does that?
Anybody that goes to the location.
How often is that done, that those tanks are checked?
Depends if they're making enough oil or whatnot. Once a week, maybe.
So do you want someone to find them?
I didn't know what else to do. That was the location I was going out to that morning.
Anyway.
I didn't know what else to do.
So you weren't thinking that far ahead?
No.
Okay.
Yesterday when you were talking, and again, this is before we kind of got to this moment today, you mentioned that, we were talking, you said, I don't know where they are, I don't know where they are, and then you said something along the lines of, whatever happened to them, this act of pure evil. What did that mean?
This is the evil that I saw when I walked behind Shanann and she was on top of CC.
And I felt evil for what I did to Shanann.
So, one other thing that doesn't make sense to me is, well, I don't know. Can you walk me through again? When you walked in, what did she look like? What did Shanann look like? All you saw was her back. Was it the same shirt that you buried her in? Same underwear? And then was she wearing pajamas?
Shanann?
Yeah.
No, that's what she sleeps in.
Oh, she sleeps in her underwear. Okay, and no pajamas, no shorts, nothing like that. So then, when you grab her, just as is, that's how she gets to the truck, that's how she gets to the site. Okay.
So did Shanann ever go to bed?
Like when I put her back in the bed?
No, like when she got home. Did any of that happen where she really, she got in bed and then you woke her up at four? Like, is all of that true? Because it looks like there's some purchase of some hair care products at like 2:30 in the morning. Do you know about that?
Hair care products?
No. And her credit card was denied? No. You said you don't really use the credit card, so the private.
My credit card, no.
Would you have bought hair care products at 2:30 in the morning that morning?
No.
Did she get mad at you because there's no money when she woke up? Like, was that part of the...
This is the first I've heard of that.
Okay.
As far as hair care products and the car being denied.
Okay. And I'm not lying about that, that's what I'm asking. No. That is something that came up.
Is there any reason she would have a black eye, Shanann?
No.
Not from a slap or a punch or nothing like that?
Never.
Okay.
Punch or slap her.
Is there any reason she would have a stab mark on her body?
No.
Okay. And no other reason for death? Coroner's not going to find rat poison in her stomach. Okay. The only way that she died, she was living, breathing, and wasn't living, breathing after your hands on her neck. Okay.
What were you talking to Nikki about before your wife got home?
Before she got home?
Mm-hmm. You talked for like several hours.
I mean, we talked a lot. Conversations, and just random conversations. We talk a lot.
Does Nikki know about any of this? Seriously?
No, she doesn't. No, like, I mean, she knows, like, with, from the news and everything like that.
Mm-hmm. Anything else? Did you share with her anything? No. Does she know your wife was pregnant?
She does now, and I told her that.
She didn't know at the time? How come you didn't tell her?
I was scared, too. Felt like, you know, like, she wouldn't even, like, gone on a date with me. She knew that, so it's...
Did she know you were married with kids?
Yes.
Okay. But just not pregnant?
Yes. I told her that, you know, like, we had actively tried before we met.
Oh, tried to get pregnant. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So she knew that.
You can imagine that when we go talk to people going forward, everyone's going to try to distance themselves from any of this.
Yes.
And so what's going to happen when Nikki says, no, it was our plan to kill everyone and run off together?
She's not going to say that.
Okay.
We're going to talk to her.
Absolutely.
We have to.
So can we get ahead of that for you? Can we get all of that out right now? I mean... So, are you sure she's not going to say, oh, I kind of knew he was going to kill him?
No.
She's not going to say
no.
That? Okay. And she's not going to say, boy, we were making plans about buying a house or an apartment. Is she going to say that?
No, like,
she really
just, like, once I have my own place, like, we could, you know, like, hang out.
more.
Okay. So after the separation, after that dust settled, then you would have availability to go see Nikki. And you guys had talks like that?
Yeah, I mean, like, she generally liked me.
Okay.
Please don't put her name out there in the news, though. She's been through enough in her lifetime.
Stuff like that, we never try to put out.
Well, I'm just knowing the press, if they got into an affair, they would drag her through the mud. I don't want that.
Yeah. We're certainly not going to try to make that happen.
Is Donner going to any of this?
I know, this press finds ways. Stuff everything.
So what do you think about everything now? Do you feel sorry for what you did?
Of course, I wouldn't have lost the control and got off his hand and then did that.
What? Took him out to the well thing?
Yes.
After we look at their bodies, we're going to have a lot more questions. Things are going to be different then, but if you're willing, we'd love to talk to you then too. You did really good today, Chris. Really good. I think you had about 24 hours of just a hellish nightmare thrust upon you, and you know, you certainly did what you did, but I think you took a lot of steps to make it better today.
Sorry I lied to you last night, and sorry I lied to you today. Not okay.
I thought you were here for a reason.
Well, there's a reason why I didn't, that I came in, because there's a reason why I didn't come in with a lawyer either, so it's like, and this is going to happen, so.
I appreciate that. You know, eventually they were going to find them out there. So, I mean, it was kind of inevitable. And you would have just been sitting at home waiting for that moment to happen. And then what? Then what does it look like?
It looks... probably...
but there's many people that say that you're an amazing guy and you would never do anything bad and has never lost your temper, and you know, all those people that say that about you, there's just as many that would say that about Shanann. So we're going to struggle with that for a while. I'm struggling with it right now, I'll be honest.
I know you are.
I'm a mom.
Anybody would.
How do we prove best that Shanann did it?
Examine the body, I guess. That's the only thing.
We're gonna see her hand marks.
The hand marks are not there.
Okay.
But there are gonna be hand marks? Like, they weren't smothered, do you think?
No, shouldn't have been smothered, no. And Bella, I don't know, but she was on top of her, and her head was inside.
And there was no pillow on top of her.
I didn't see you on the camera off. I didn't see one on top of her.
Why were there sheets in the trash in the kitchen?
Because those are the same ones out there. I didn't know what else to do. I knew eventually I was going to find Shanann. I mean, has.
So is she still wrapped in the sheet in, down in here?
Mm-hmm. It was just laying out to the side, or maybe the wind took it.
So it's right here now?
Yeah.
It was just next to the side?
Yeah.
Like you didn't even try and hide that?
I was so scared, I didn't know what to do.
Did someone come up on you or something?
No.
Okay.
Were you afraid they were going to start showing up?
I knew they were on their way out there, but I mean, it's a long way out there.
So I know, and before I forget, I know that they collected a lot of electronics out of your house,
mm-hmm.
like routers and that kind of stuff. Like, that's not going to show that she was using her phone, like, at a time that you said
mm-hmm.
she was strangling the kids or
mm-hmm.
something, right? Okay. What is the password to, like, all the electronics in your house? I know there was an iPad.
iPad should be 2385.
2385. There's not one for the Apple Watches, is there?
Should be 2385.
Is that for yours, too?
3387.
I'm sorry, what was yours?
3387.
3387. And what other stuff do you have? Is there a router, like, is there a password for that stuff?
Shiny Chair 6.
Okay.
Came with the router.
And spell for me.
Shinychair 6. Number 6.
Like that. Shiny Chair 6?
Yes.
Okay. And then what else was in that? Is there a desktop computer?
Yeah, that one. If it has a password, it'd be 428-4915, capital S, lowercase w.
Okay. And what about, is there anything else in the house as far as electronics go, tablets?
Well, the iPad's the only real set. The other ones are the kids' stuff, but they're just like Amazon Fires or whatnot.
Okay. And you have an iPhone, what? Which one? Is that your personal one?
Yes, iPhone, like, it's a 7 Plus or something.
What's the password to that one?
3387.
And what about your work phone?
Same.
Is that this one here?
Mm-hmm.
Then, obviously, Shanann had an iPhone, right?
Mm-hmm.
And what was her password?
So it changed to 013119.
What was that password?
The due date, the next day.
Okay.
Nikki told me that one. Nicole told me that one.
Okay.
So that's me, Nikki's, Nicole's.
Yeah, we noticed that. It was getting us very confused. So no other electronics. What about the Echo? Does it have a password?
If it does, I don't never knew if it did or not.
Okay.
You just say Alexa and it starts listening.
Oh, it's an Alexa? Is it the Echo still?
So, yeah.
Okay.
The product's called an Echo.
Okay. Any other ones that you can think of? Okay.
Where do you guys bank?
Chase in USA.
Which one was the, when you went out to dinner with Nikki?
Chase.
That was Chase. And USAA, is that mortgage? Is that bank? Is that
both? Chase is our mortgage lender.
Okay.
Do you have checking through them too, right?
Yes.
What do you guys use USAA for?
We use that to pay mortgage too, but
okay.
It's just another, she had that before she met me.
Okay. And in the accounts that you had personally, beyond all of this?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh, the security system. Was it Vivint, right?
Vivint, yeah.
Vivint.
That's either going to be 3387 or 2385. One or two. And the passcode, like is Mustang for if you ever have to talk to them. Verbal passcode.
And then what email is associated with that?
ShanannWatts@gmail.com.
Do you know her email password?
Could read that 428-4915. It should, any of her, if most of her password is that.
Okay.
Amazon, everything.
Yeah, what is that? Is that a phone number you said?
Yeah.
What phone number is that?
Her ex-husband's mom.
Okay, that's weird.
You stick with the password.
She just remembers it? She's had it that long.
They were really good friends.
Oh, okay.
So she just kept it.
Do you have any other questions for us?
Here's the bathroom.
Yes.
Of course.
We do need to do one quick thing. Now that we know what we know, we're going to, I need to check that you don't have any weapons on you or anything like that. Do you have any weapons on you?
No.
Okay. We'll do that. We'll go to the bathroom. I'm not going to go in the stall with you, but I'm going to go with you. And then we'll come right back here and we'll make a decision about how the rest of the night goes. All right, so you might stand it up so I can check it. All right. All right, let's go to the bathroom.
Okay, so you listen in?
Yes, please.
president.
We're going to make a decision on your property. Okay. I'm going to take it with me for now, though. And then just for everyone's protection, I'm going to leave that recording.
Okay.
Yes.